Hey hockey fans, welcome to another edition of Coach's Corner. My name is Mike Pearson, I'm your host, and today we're with Lakeville North Boys Varsity Head Coach Trent Eigner. Coach, welcome to the broadcast.
Thank you.
Good to have you here today. So let's start first with the holiday tournament. Before we talk mid-season update, the team was involved with holiday tournament at Dakota Ice Arena. Faced some good competition, some respected teams in terms of rankings in the state of Minnesota. So if you wouldn't mind sharing a little bit about your takeaways from the tournament. I know the team faced Eden Prairie, Prior Lake, and Stillwater. All really good games. My takeaway on the weekend was we were competitive. We looked good in all the games. Be interested to hear your take on it.
For sure. I mean, I think the one thing I want to touch on, just moving forward, what a great field, you know, that venue provided, you know, Edina and St. Thomas, ourselves, Stillwater and Chaska was up and coming. So it was just kind of had a great vibe to be amongst a great group of teams. To leave there 1-2 is kind of misleading for us in terms of wins, losses. Being dinged up, which is kind of what has been our MO since the get-go, it just kind of forces constant lineup changes. We just haven't had that continuity. But, you know, I consider empty net games one-goal games. So, you know, with 50 seconds left, we're tied with Stillwater. You know, pretty good hockey team. We lose there late. With 4 minutes left, you know, we're tied with Eden Prairie. We kind of lose there late again. So, you know, this is the way at least I've chosen to look at the season when you lose so many guys to injury early on. You kind of have to bide your time and understand that you're developing a bunch of guys in situations that wouldn't normally play. And if you can kind of just tread water and keep your mojo a little bit and not get too tough on, you know, critiquing yourself, the second half of the season could be promising in that sense. I feel like as we continue to implement guys back into the lineup, we'll hopefully find some continuity and probably be a better hockey team for having struggled in the first half.
No question. I thought the team was very competitive, and then you had Sam Anovic come back, Anello was back, and you had some guys that hadn't been involved in the season. So you're right, it's going to take some time for everybody to get their legs underneath them and get the team chemistry where you want it.
For sure. I mean, you'd never have any expectation that a guy, you know, it's very, the doctor clearing you to play and being ready to play are two very different things in terms of being able to contribute. Right. So we had a bunch of guys, and right now we've got a bunch of guys that are kind of fresh back in there. I don't think it's fair to expect too much too early, but you know it's meaningful minutes that they're getting now in terms of getting themselves back in what I call hockey shape. And so, like I said, I mean we're very confident that in the latter half of the season when we get our lineup back in order and get some continuity, that we can be very competitive.
Wow. Just a side note, we lost Sam Anovic for the season. It sounds like he's out for the rest of the season due to surgery.
Yeah, I mean, that's just one of them deals for a young kid. It's terrible. Yeah. I think he played 4 periods all season. You know, so I think he dinged it up, that shoulder, in the second game of the season. You know, came back and suited up, maybe played 2 shifts, one game there just to get his feet back, and then boom, popped the same shoulder out. So, yeah, unfortunate, but obviously now he'll spend his time being our number one cheerleader the rest of the way.
Great leader, great kid. They'll miss having him on the ice, but he'll be a positive influence off the ice for sure. Let's talk mid-season update. Believe it or not, we're halfway through the high school season already. It's a quick season. It goes fast. And I think we're 8-5, if I got the record right, 7-1 in the conference. So the conference record very strong. Maybe talk a little bit about observations to this point in the season in terms of how the team's done to this point and maybe some of the things you guys are thinking about focusing on second half.
Well, without trying to be too redundant, I think that, you know, we struggled to create a ton of offense in the first half of the season, yet we were able to win hockey games. And I think if you're going to be an optimist, which I generally am, if you can learn to play under those circumstances and figure out ways to win, the hope is that when you do start scoring goals, you'd probably be a pretty tough team to compete against because you're so ingrained into that defensive mindset, knowing that you know you're only scoring 2 a game, and you need to hold teams in check if you're going to win games. So if we do blossom a little bit offensively in the second half, which you know we're hopeful that we will, that lends to probably some favorable outcomes for us. You know, the other thing is there is a chemistry part of team sports, you know, that things need to fit together the right way, and that doesn't always happen, you know, at first glance. You know, so you put some line combinations together, and sometimes you get a ton out of this line, but you realize you've sucked all the life out of the other ones. You juggle it around, and you know, with the goal being that you can have three or four competitive lines that go out there with some jam and can play. And I don't know that we've found that very often this year with the amount of injuries we've had. So I think that just that type of chemistry through consistency a little bit, you know, will provide us a little boost as well. But our goaltending's been fantastic. You know, we got 3 10th grade defensemen that are logging a ton of minutes. And as you move through the season, you know, that lends itself to some good things in the second half. So I agree with you. It's hard to believe that, you know, you're halfway through it. But I always remind our seniors, man, just blink and it's over.
For sure. Final question, maybe some thoughts as we go into the second half of the season, what the team's going to be focused on.
Well, for sure, the push is kind of a combination of when you play this much hockey in a kind of a short period of time, you got to be cognizant of guys physically and mentally and emotionally, whether they're fresh. It's very different from the beginning of the season where you're trying to kind of get your sea legs and you're in that grind mode. And now, you know, it's more about, hey, how many times can we shake up the pop can and let it go and get that explosion? And so we'll start to kind of narrow our focus on that game prep and just refining things rather than beating the tar out of each other every day. So that's kind of the way the season's always evolved for us. And it's different in the sense that, you know, when you've had that level of success, that seems to be kind of the bar that gets set, you know, and you win. Well, I consider myself fortunate to have won that championship with that team, because now it doesn't feel like the weight of the world is on every game. What becomes important is are you progressing towards a good postseason run? And I think that's all you want to do. And so, you know, I've learned a lot from a lot of older coaches, Mike Randolph especially, that, you know, you take the first 10 games to figure out what you got, you take the second 10 to get your combinations right, and you take the last 5 to get ready to be a good team when it matters. So, you know, I don't really pay that much attention to our record or our ranking. I think when I was a younger coach, those things were probably far more prevalent as you're trying to build an identity for a program. But I think that for the most part, people realize when they play a Lakeville North team, they better compete pretty hard. And so now we can kind of, you know, focus on kind of that refinement towards a great push in those last 5. And if we're healthy and fresh and emotionally charged going into a section tournament, then that's what you kind of shoot for.
It's hard to imagine, but the postseason feels like it might be just right around the corner. But good luck the rest of the way, Coach. We appreciate you joining us today. Thanks for your time. We've been joined today by Lakeville North Boys Varsity Head Coach Trent Eigner. This has been another edition of Coach's Corner. Check in with us each week for updates and insights into Lakeville North Boys Hockey. Thanks for checking in, everyone. We'll see you at the rink.